I have a few more names, but I don't think because 6 o'clock is the time given. Point is, sense of the house always says bada, magar log ka sankhya kam hote jate hai. We will have often our extension. Then Sri Amar Patnaik, 2 minutes, please.
Thank you, sir. It's a proud privilege for me today to be a part of this historic occasion, historic debate as well. So I would not like to repeat what the honorable members have said, but in a sense, as it appears, so the Rajya Sabha has been at the forefront of bringing out some of the most outstanding socio-economic legislations. If the Lok Sabha has had a preeminence on the money bills, the Rajya Sabha has had some of the outstanding socio-economic legislations like the Hindu Marriage and Divorce Bill, which we discussed in the morning today, India's succession, the Succession Amendment Bill 1991, the marriage laws, several of these laws. The most important, so the historic Women Reservation Bill, on which our Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik has been repeatedly writing to, demanding this both publicly as well as been writing and has been telling us, this was passed in this house. And it has not been passed in the Lok Sabha. So if I would say that if there is one particular progressive house between the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, it is the Rajya Sabha which has been fighting for the women of this country. And it is the double engine. It is the double engine, actual double engine of growth, and not the same government at the state at the center. Even Honorable Prime Minister said today that if it is the growth process of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, as he said, to progress, then both the houses should go, that it is the true double engine is when Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha work in tandem. The second thing is, so what Praful Patel ji has said, that one of the challenges is about the whip, the anti-defection bill, sir. So the anti-defection bill is to stop defections. But what in a sense happens is that you are also prohibited from speaking your mind, even though you broadly agree. Even when there is a committee of, let's say there are three judges bench, one particular judge may have a judgment which is concurring, but he can write a separate judgment. Now, such kind of views are not probably possible in Lok Sabha, but that should be allowed in the Rajya Sabha. That should be possible, and that should be the hallmark of Rajya Sabha. One has to think about it. The second aspect, sir, is the discussion, sir. So the National Commission, sir, which was set up to review the working of the Constitution, made mention of the absence of adequate parliamentary scrutiny. It noted that the bills are often pushed in the Parliament with unbelievable speed and then found wanting in one respect or another, and recommended a more systemic approach to planning legislation. Sir, while changing is very good, but changing too frequently is bad. It probably reflects that we have not really applied our mind too much. And therefore, the committee, all the debate that we have been having about the standing committees, I think it has to have, it has to be taken in a proper perspective, and the scope for deliberation has to be made preeminent, as observed by Dr. Radhakrishnan when he said that so far as its deliberative functions are concerned, it will be open to Rajya Sabha members to make very valuable contributions, and it will depend on our work whether we justify this two-chamber system, which is now an integral part of our constitution, and so it is a test to which we are submitted, we as members are submitted. And Mr. Arun Jaitley, about whom we talked about in the morning today, the people look upon both the houses of parliament to improve the quality of politics and governance. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Amarji.